you, Ms. Paragetopoulou. Any questions, please? No. Thank you. Now, Dr. Skaropoulou now presents another interesting presentation on aeroplanes. Dr. Skaropoulou has studied chemical engineering at the National Technical University of Athens. In 2007, she earned her Master of Science in Science and Technology of Materials and in the departmental postgraduate course. In 2009, she got her PhD thesis, durability of limestone cement pasts, mortars and concretes exposed to sulfate attack. For 4 years, she worked in an industry that produced and commercialized paints, mortars and adhesives. She's working now as a senior researcher at the School of Chemical Engineers at National Technical University of Athens. Her project concerns the development of thermal insulation materials from inorganic materials.
In the case of freeze drying, We have to apply low temperature and pressure, while in the case of supercritical time, we have to apply high temperature and high pressure. In more details, supercritical line works by preparing a gel using salt gel method. The liquid on gel spot is a solvent or water. So we have to soak the gel in pure organic solvent several times to remove water from its pores. And then we have to heat the gel at solvent temperature, critical temperature and pressure. Here you can see a table with some solvent with critical temperature and pressure. It's a characteristics for this solvent. And these values shows the state in which the gaseous and liquid phase of the solvent are indistinguished. As you can see, these values are high enough, so in that case we have to take extra precautions because these solvents can be flammable or may explode. Some of the application of supercritical drying is drying of spices, production of biogel, and the contamination of coffee. This is the freeze dryer that we have at our lab, and at this figure you can see how freeze drying works. At the beginning, following the blue arrow, at the beginning we have to freeze the material, then to reduce the surrounding pressure by applying vacuum, and then we have to sublime the frozen water, the salt of the ice, pass directly to the gas phase. This process is going around the breaking point, avoiding the direct transition from liquid to gas phase. There are four stages in the complete drying complete drying process. It's the pre-treatment if the liquid meets it, the freezing stage, the primary is drying. In this stage, we have to the removal of free water, and the secondary drying or desorption drying. In this case, in this stage, we have the removal of bonded water. Here are some applications of the freeze drying. It is used in pharmaceutical and biotechnology, in food and agricultural based industries, and in technological industries. Let's focus on aeroclase, which is the subject of our work. The bentonite can be calcium or sodium. Divalent cations are link the platelets into stacks. When they absorb water, the distance of the layers from 1.5 nanometers become 2 nanometers. In the case of monovalent cations, the bentonite, they can hydrate to such an extent so the platelets can be separated from each other. And that's why the distance of the layer can be from 1.2 nanometer to an infinite number. Here you can see all this in these two pictures. And using the single freeze drying step, the platelets link face to face in a matter of a house of cards, as you can see in picture 3. Here are some uses of aeroclase. Depending on the reinforcement agent, aeroclase can attach some properties. So they can become an absorber. As an absorber, they can pick up oil spills from other solution, high-tech kiliter, a vacuum material. As an insulator, they can become an insulator, thermal and acoustic, an industrial conductor. For example, by incorporating nickel particles, they can become an ultra-wave magnet. All these uses are in experimental stage. Only high-tech kiliter and packing material, there is effort for these materials to be commercialized, to be on market, in the United States. Here you can see some insulating materials with their properties. Their thermal conductivity range from 0.03 to 0.45. And for mineral in glass wool, they are classified as non-combustible materials, while the insulating materials with polystyrene are classified as not easily flammable. In Greece, the most common insulating material is expanded polystyrene. For the synthesis of fire of the air, you have to mix clay with water, steam to mix the air, cosmetate. After the molding of the suspension, you have to freeze it and freeze dyeing. The raw material we used was clay, sodium chloride as clay, and as a reinforcement agent, we used polyvinyl alcohol, PVA, casein, and cellulose fibers. We would like to see how the temperature affects the synthesis of fire clays. That's why we examine this temperature. The iron clay should have low density and low thermal conductivity. In order to find the percentages of NMP, PPA and temperature compared to density, to minimum density, a multifactorial model that we should apply. As you can see, minimum density had the synthesis with 5% NMP, 5% PPA and minus 30 Celsius degree. You can also see the contribution of each parameter. The most important parameter is PVA. Here are some photos of the samples. Starting from the left, you can see the aeroplanes of cellulose fiber with NMP, casein with NMP aeroplane, PVA and NMP aeroplane. The aeroplane with cellulose fiber turned into dust, while the samples with casein PVA, casein of high content of PVA, of MMP and casein and PVA, was received as monoliths. Here you can see some photos of PVA and of aeroplane of different sizes. And here is a photo of PVA with MMP aeroplane burned by hand torch, using propylene as fuel gas. The surface was exposed to flame for about 60 seconds. As you can see, the surface is burnt, but the spread has a very slow rate. And no flame was observed at the surface of the sample. Here are the experiments we have already done. The density depends on the condition of the synthesis. The minimum density was 0.07 gram per cubic centimeter. Here you can see the density and thermal conductivity for different percentages of NMP and PVA. The blue columns are for thermal conductivity and the red one represents density. The addition of NMP and PVA leads to aeroplanes, to products more stiff and solid. Comparing the first and the third volumes, you can see that by the addition of the PVA, the density increases while the thermal conductivity is similar. And comparing the first two volumes, we can see that by the addition of MMP, both density and the thermal conductivity increase. Here are XRT patterns of selected products. As MMP is the raw material, and we have the aeroplanes of MMP with PVA, MMP with casein, and MMP with cellulose fiber. The patterns are similar. The main component is homoiodized, while bentonite calcite and advanced was identified as minor components. the difference are focused at three small decreases. As you can see, the sampling of cellulose fiber is similar to the pattern of MMP. The pitch at 7 degrees absent in the case of calcium, while in the case of TBA, this peak is shifted into smaller decreases. This peak corresponds to the interlayer spacing, and by the adding of TBA, this space increases. Here are the layer thickness with black and spacing with red for clay compared to freezing temperature. For clay aerogel and clay aerogel with the reinforcement agent, with PTA. As you can see, the freezing temperature affects the layer thickness and spacing. In the case of insulating materials, we would like to have small layer thickness and bigger spacing. Of course, we want a solid material. If we have a solid material, we would like to have smaller layer thickness and bigger space. Here are some photos. At the top, you can see two same photos of MMP PVA at same magnifications. You can see that the reinforcement, that the different reinforcement agents leads to different structure. And at the bottom, you can see two same photos of MMP with PVA, different magnifications. At the right, you can see the very fine lamellar structure of the aeroplane, and the distance of the layer is 30 to 60 microns. While at the left, you can see the strands of polymer between the layers. From all the above, we conclude that the freeze drying has many advantages compared to supercritical drying. Solid monomerionite with PVA and the monomerionite with casein of high content can be used for the synthesis of aerogel. The synthesis route involves mixing of the reagents, freezing of the sample, sublimation of the water via freeze drying. The content of the reagents in the starting solution and the freezing temperature affect the density and the thermal conductivity. The factors with the highest impact on the density were the content of MMP and the reinforcement agent, and the kind of reinforcement agent affects the structure of aeroclase. We believe that aeroclase could be a competitive product compared to other insulating materials. Thank you very much.